Shaquille O'Neal on 2K Sports, and the NBA season is about to begin. In a few moments, we'll be sending you out to Philadelphia as the 76ers go up against the Boston Celtics. Well, for Boston, it's always an exciting time of the year as fans and other players and coaches around the league all getting a first look at how they might be shaping up for the upcoming season. In his rookie season, Jared Sullinger was learning under Paul Pierce and Kevin Garnett. Those guys.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, sir. Let's do it. Yes, sir. Yo.
Yeah. 2K Sports checks in with our loyal viewers with a broadcast from Philadelphia. It's the home of the 76ers, the Wells Fargo Center. Kevin Harlan here with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. Thanks for joining us on this Saturday afternoon. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. So let's take a look at the Boston Celtics starting lineup. At the 2-3, it's Avery Bradley and Jeff Green. Brandon Bass is out there with Jared Sullinger. And it's Rondo in at the 1. Left side, Bradley. No good off the back of the rim.
Well, the history of college coaches switching over to the NBA is pretty daunting, but Brad Stevens of the Celtics can't worry about those who came before him. He's just got to be himself, and he was well-regarded in Boston. Despite the fact that they went through a rebuilding process last year, he did a really good job.
Here's Rondo, and let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Well, earlier I spoke with Brad Stevens. We talked about the keys in preparing for this game, and he said, well, defense is always our first priority. And while we don't want our shot blockers risking foul trouble, having that backstop does enable our perimeter guys the freedom to play up and aggressive. So, Kevin, pressure D and shot blocking, something to look out for.
Okay, thank you, Doris. And the defensive approach, guys, how do you think that'll play out here?
I don't know, Kevin. I'm not sure they should be more focused on their opponent than they are on themselves.
That is sort of the way it sounds, Steve, but still, I don't think a defense-first mindset is ever a bad thing. There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Here's Carter Williams, again, Philadelphia.
Nice kick out after the defense had collapsed on him.
Here's Rondo. The feed to Sullinger. Pulls up on the wing. That one goes. Counts. Sullinger's got his first 2 points. Just about 2 minutes into the game. First quarter of basketball. Here's Embiid. First three-pointer's off the mark.
I like that he has the confidence to take that shot, but I'm not sure if that's within his range. Well, Joel Embiid, born in Cameroon, the son of a professional handball player, only started playing basketball at the age of 16. He's been playing soccer and volleyball, but I'll tell you, his development in the game has been rapid.
Now the 76ers on the break. And Thompson gets it to go in on the assist by Noel. Thompson's got 5 now.
You know, when the size advantage is that pronounced, I mean, that's exactly what you should do offensively in this situation. Take it strong to the middle.
Now here's Brent. The runner. And Bass kicks to Sullinger. The pass to Rondo. And that one's good.
Assisted. Jeff Green.
1:57 left to play in the first. And for Embiid, his countryman and NBA veteran, Luke Richard Mbamute, spotted him at a camp in Africa. That was the start of it all.
Came over to the U.S., didn't play a whole lot in high school, expected to redshirt at Kansas, but ended up starting from day one. And the thing I liked about him was he almost improved, not just game to game. You could see improvement within game.
That's a great point. You're right. And here is Noel following Jeff Green's three. It's Thompson off the drive. And the shot is good. Thompson's got 7. Boston trailing. So the Celtics call timeout. They're first. 76ers with a completely new group now. And some changes here for the Celtics. .112 left to play here in the first. Smart dishes to Thornton. The 11-footer. Second chance shot. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Boston shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line. He misses the free throw.
You know, I just love Kelly Olynyk's great skill level. He can handle and shoot the ball beyond the arc, but also a polished low post score inside. So you can run offense through him, and that's really a great dynamic for his team.
Now here's Williams.
Good. They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from inside the paint area.
The defense has to make an adjustment. They've got to string together some stops, or at the very least, try to force this team into some bad shots.
Here's Turner. Philadelphia getting their last shot to go. Smart kicks to Turner. The shot misses. Nice D from Williams. He dishes it to Davis. Feeds to Schved. Good work defensively by Turner.
All the defender had to do there was just stay close to him, and he did.
It's tipped. Olynyk the pass to Smart. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Olynyk sets a screen for Smart. In the corner, Thornton with it. Two open that time. Made it look too easy.
And that's why teams emphasize the use of screens and picks, just to get you some open looks like that one.
Stolen by Smart. Wallace goes in to the inside and stolen by Williams. Up the floor. Here's Sims. And it's good, but hold on. The officials may want to look at that one on the replay monitor. And it looks like they are going to review the play. The question, did he get the basket off in time?
I think you're going to be able to see pretty clearly on the replay that the shot left his hands in time, guys. The evidence is right there.
Yeah, and this is a big call, guys. I mean, they're going to take a very close look at it, even if it seems clear-cut at first glance.
The first quarter all wrapped up, and it's been an exciting game so far. 76ers lead by two. And don't go away. We'll be back with the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment. Welcome back, folks. We have a close game here at the start of the second quarter of play. What stands out to you guys from the 76ers in this one?
And a good start for this club. I like the way they played together, really moved the ball and did a nice job offensively.
Yeah, excellent ball movement, and it's paid off on the scoreboard, too.
The 76ers leading. These youthful Sixers club really trying to play a full tilt open court style.
Yeah, they want to play up tempo under head coach Brett Brown.
Wow. What a throwdown. Look at that athletic play. Incredible.
Wow. I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is the 2 points, not the dramatics.
Oh, come on. Barb, you had to go for it, didn't you?
I'm with you, Kevin. You can't fault him for that. I mean, just let him go. Who cares?
Wallace with a screen on Mbah Mutha. Thornton dishes to Smart. Wallace with a screen for Smart. A second chance effort. And, there's a whistle. He was going up for a layup. And while it looked like there was some contact, I wasn't sure they were going to call it a foul shot or not. But sure enough, they have. So he'll head to the free throw line.
Two shots.
Gerald Wallace undergoing knee and ankle surgeries in an early end to last season. For a player so dependent on his athleticism, it'll be interesting to see how he does coming back now at the age of 32.
The Celtics making a switch here. Jared Sollinger's checked in for Kelly Olynyk. Green comes in for Evan Turner. Bradley's checked in for Marcus Thornton. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Smart. Rondo kicks to Bradley. Passes it to Wallace. That's good. Wallace has got 4 points now in the quarter. And Wallace last season battling gamely on a rebuilding Celtics team.
Yeah, it was an interesting attempt at a fit for Wallace. I mean, the team was going young, and he's near the tail end of his career, so it's not ideal for him or the team, but nonetheless, he's always been a pro that works extremely hard and brings value wherever he's been.
Philadelphia shooting their first free throw. First trip to the line in this one.
Well, you look at the numbers, Kevin. Last year, they were around 71% from the line as a team. So not a very good number there.
And it's something they know that if they improve, can really have a big impact on their success.
Catching up on the changes for Philadelphia. Embiid, he's checked in for Arnett Moultrie. Noel comes in for Jason Richardson. And Michael Carter-Williams subbed in for Williams. Stupendous rush to the rim and a mighty slam on the end of it.
But through the teeth of some pretty soft D, I can't help but say that.
Well, let's see how that impacts things here, because those kinds of plays sometimes can be game changers on both sides. Nice pass. That one was right on target.
For Boston, they've gotten four of their first five shots to fall in the second quarter. Outstanding shooting. Rondo against Carter Williams. Bass. And it's Noel with the rebound. 76ers have gone a nice 3-3 to start the second. And Bamute, the pass to Noel. Here's Embiid again, Philadelphia.
These guys know each other well, clearly, because that was a beautiful pass.
And the Celtics with possession here. Four-point game. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
Well, Nerlens Noel's rookie season, essentially a medical redshirt, recovered from ACL surgery in early 2013. So this will be his true rookie season.
Some changes for Philadelphia. Moultrie's checked in for Noel. Grant comes in for Mbamute. And Elliott Williams subs in for Roten. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Thank you, Kevin. Brad Stevens had some words for his team over the break. He touched on his desire to see them make heavy use of the pick and roll for the rest of the game. Keep setting those screens, fellas. Those were his exact words. He said also that their offense needs to be a patient one. He told them, don't rush things. Use as much of that shot clock as you need to. Well, coach not wasting any time in tweaking the game plan. We'll see if it makes a difference as we approach halftime, Kevin.
Great. Thanks for the report, Doris. There's 1:38 left in the second quarter. Bradley dishes to Rondo. Pass to Green. Good. And it's Rondo who picks up the assist. Rondo's got three assists now in this one. And Nerlens Noel projected as the number one draft pick based on his defensive impact as a freshman Clark at Kentucky. But the knee injury dropped him to number six.
Yeah, you're drafting that high. General manager's looking for an immediate impact player in the draft. Concerns about that knee and his slight build caused him to slide. But if he gets healthy and add some weight to that frame, I think he could be a real presence defensively.
The drive by Green, just five on the clock. Rondo kicks to Sullivan. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
Well, that's how you send it. Two hands and hammer it down.
Grant kicks to Williams. He feeds it to Carter Williams. Solid shot from the distance of about 14 feet. Carter Williams has got six.
Really did a nice job recognizing the mismatch that he had and immediately cashing in with that mid-range jumper.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Austin shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game.
About a year ago, they converted about 78% of their free throws as a team, so pretty solid there.
You know, Kevin, they would love to post a similar percentage again this season. I mean, I think that's safe to say they'd love to shoot free throws as well as they did a year ago.
Here's what Philadelphia's going with right now. Sims is checked in. That's Thompson in for Grant. Then for the Celtics, Olynyk is checked in for Jared Sullinger. Turner comes in for Jeff Green. And Smart subbed in for Avery Bradley. Got a piece of it. Fast break. Here we go. Goes up. And it's Moultrie slamming it down.
And unfortunately, we've seen a few too many of those. Lack of concentration and alertness, a turnover, and an easy bucket the other way in transition.
And if we see a few more of them, this game could be in danger of getting out of hand quickly.
And so that's the end of the first half. Philadelphia ahead, leading by seven. start the second half, beginning in just a moment.
Just absolute domination in this one. For Green, he has 8 points, and he's done a little bit of work behind the arc. He's got a pair of three-pointers.
Well, the defenders have that in the back of their minds now, too, so they're going to close out on him quicker. That should allow him to use the drive if he wants.
The second half just about to get going here. One guy who's getting it done is Jeff Green.
I like that he didn't force anything in that first half. His decision-making was really flawless.
That being the case, Steve, I think they want him to be more assertive in the second half. Look to take more shots. Be a little more shot-hungry, even the tough ones.
We've got Mbah Amute. Noel is out there with Embiid. Then there's Richardson. And it's Roten in at the two-guard spot. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. And Doris Burke has a report for us from the sideline.
Guys, as you know, Michael Carter Williams, last year's Rookie of the Year, and Coach Brett Brown said he's more than he's bargained for. More skilled, tougher, prideful, and competitive. But Coach loves his playmaking as well, saying, quote, his size enables him to play with a different vision line. He understands how to run a team and find his teammates. Kevin?
Not bad for the number 10 pick in the draft. Thanks, Doris. There's the block.
Oh, they're now plus five in the rebound category, really controlling the glass.
And rebounding is one of those non-glamour stats. I mean, it takes work and effort and tenacity and physicality. But when you look at the scoreboard, you can see the correlation.
It had been six straight years for the Celtics that they had made the playoffs, but that run came to an end last season as they were clearly in full rebuild mode.
Second half rolling along now, about a minute played here. Lock at six. Bradley passes to Sellinger. The lead pass was put in just the right spot. Sellinger's got 6 points.
The 2 points are pretty much a lock when they're able to get the ball into that position inside.
Here is Mbah Amute. Green with the block. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
Now, severe lack of awareness on his part. He had no idea he was near the out of bounds line.
The 76ers leading by seven. Here's Embiid. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. 6 points for him.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these easy chances is going to do wonders for their confidence.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
Been a couple of whirlwind years for Joel Embiid. Coming from Cameroon, had to learn a new culture, new cuisine, how to drive a car. Now he's a top pick, making millions of dollars a year. That's enough to make anybody's head spin. A lot to adjust to. But with his fluidity and the natural gift he seems to have for the game, I get the feeling this young man's going to be just fine.
Here's what Philadelphia's going with right now. Brandon Davies has checked in for Noel. Williams comes in for Mbah Amute. And it's Alexi Shved in for Richardson.
And they've been off target now on three of the first four shots they've taken in this second half.
And that one's good, Shved. And Embiid with a stress fracture in his back in March, a stress fracture in his foot in June. Clark, those kinds of injuries raise long-term concerns, especially when you're talking about a seven-footer with a very limited basketball resume.
Well, there's no denying that, Kevin. I mean, clearly, if you're a general manager, then you're thinking about what are the prospects of this big, talented, highly gifted player going forward, and only time will tell if this is just an aberration or it's something that's going to be chronic.
Rondo drives in, and so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Well, at least the defender got his money's worth on that one.
Yep, that was an easy whistle for the official.
So far in the game, he's 0-2 at the line.
Well, and you know, you'll take what you can from him from the foul line. A season ago, he shot in that low 60% range.
You know, yeah, guys, last year was a rough one for him at the stripe. I mean, it's going to be hard for him not to improve on those numbers. They were that bad.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Walls has checked in for Bax. Young is subbed in for Avery Bradley. Tries from 10, and again, it's Philadelphia.
And we're seeing the shots just dropping from everywhere right now.
Yeah, since halftime, Steve, they've been operating very efficiently.
Outside Rondo. Wallace dishes to Rondo, and the wide-open shot from Green. Boston again missing.
Hard work on the glass once again, fellas. They put a lot of effort into their rebound.
Well, you get more rebounds, you get more possessions, more shots at the hoop, and oftentimes that decides the game.
Well, the Celtics certainly played with a lot of passion last year. They got off to a start that few thought they would achieve, but even playing with passion can't cover up the holes in the roster.
Now let's go to Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, guys, Brett Brown overseeing a major rebuild project as head coach of the Sixers. He said, you can get tricked by potential, but ultimately it gets down to integrity, character, competitiveness, and toughness. When you cut to the chase, those qualities mean more to me. Those non-negotiables keep me on track. They ground me. Kevin, fascinating stuff.
So much of building a team and a program is defining that culture and the expectations. Thanks, Doris. Catching up on the changes for Philadelphia. Sims is checked in. Moultrie comes in for Brandon Davies. Thompson, he's checked in for Williams. And Michael Carter-Williams subbed in for Roten.
Boy, the kind of moments you love to see. Excellent defense leading to a dunk at the other end.
Clark, you got to marvel at the transition game when they've got it clicking. It's really explosive.
High octane for sure.
Yeah, turning defensive pressure into offensive opportunities. That's what it's all about.
Celtics trail by 15. You got to give the Celtics credit, though. They were never really in contention for anything last year, but Clark, they played their heart.
Yeah, they did play hard, play with energy. And that goes a long way to trying to build the foundation of being successful going forward. It might not have done much for them last year, but that attitude is something they can build on.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
He can't be pleased with all these easy looks they continue to give up in the paint.
They are just way too porous as a defense right now. A lot of holes in that defense. It's a good time to use a timeout here.
Ambala Mute is checked in for Philadelphia. Williams comes in for Alexi Shved. Boston also with the sub. Thornton's checked in. 40 seconds left in the third. Looking to end the run. Good as the jump shot falls. Thornton's got his second basket. The 76ers leading by 15. Carter Williams kicks to Moultrie. Pass to Ambala Mute. Cranes the three-pointer.
How many times have you seen a possession like that from them today, ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass?
Well, if you just looked at assists as the measuring stick, they've been by far the better team.
Smart, wide open, he fires. No good off the front iron.
I think he was surprised by how much space he had there and just rushed the shot a little bit.
From deep, Williams. No good. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. 76ers lead by 18. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get started for the fourth quarter. How about a look at today's State Farm assist of the game?
Yeah, let's do it. I love the way this play developed. I think this offense really thrives off of plays like that. Turned it into an easy basket.
And the Celtics with possession here. They trail by 18. Our fourth quarter action underway, presented by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups. On the floor for Boston, Evan Turner is out there with Brandon Vance. Then it's Thornton. Then it's Olynyk. And it's Smart in at the point guard. And Embiid throws it down.
The defense just couldn't recover in time.
Yeah, the D pretty much went brain neutral on that one, Clark. Wouldn't you?
Yes, sir. I like that phrase.
Yeah, I don't use that phrase very often, but to me, that's what happened. He shifted the brain into neutral.
Yes, he did.
That was embarrassing.
And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the boards.
Well, the main thing is they haven't allowed many second chance opportunities. And that is always going to allow you to maintain your lead.
The shot by Carter Williams, nobody around. Off target with the open look. And pushing it up, here's Boston. Horton's got the ball. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. Evan Turner to start last season, a featured offensive player. Steve for the rebuilding 76.
Yeah, Andre Iguodala and Drew Holiday traded away in consecutive seasons. So Turner's numbers went up with the team struggling, but you know, he didn't seem very happy about the roster changes because, boy, they were losing night in and night out.
here's what Boston's going with right now. Sellinger's checked in for Olynyk. Green comes in for Marcus Thornton. Rajon Rondo is subbed in for Smart. Bradley's checked in for Boston. Fourth quarter, still young, just over a minute play.
And Turner traded from the Sixers to the Pacers at the deadline. That was a change not only in role, but also in record. Going from...
Oh, my goodness. What a huge play. And the defense paying instant dividends. Fast break basket.
Yeah, that transition was immediate. Didn't waste a second getting out on the break.
Another shot, and Embiid lays it in. Embiid's got 10 points in just the second half.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there.
Well, Rajon Rondo still in a Celtics uniform, and that doesn't seem like a foregone conclusion over the last season. Boston in the midst of a complete rebuild, and Rondo already in the prime of his career, so a lot of discussion about a possible trade.
Noel's checked in for Philadelphia. Grant comes in for Roten.
You know, you look at Rondo and you get the sense that perhaps he covets a chance to lead the Celtics as the team's undisputed franchise player. You know, that's a mantle he's not quite carried in his career. He said he'd love to have another 10 years in Boston.
Dishes to Green. Bradley, no one around him. Drills the three-pointer. Bradley's got 5 points now this quarter.
D there, guys, was pretty much non-existent. I mean, you can't leave a good shooter like that open.
Kicks it to Bass. The Celtics working the ball around now. Bradley with the ball. Now defended by Carter Williams. Now for the Celtics, have to give up an elite player like Rondo.
Well, Brad Stevens called him their clear-cut best player and the leader of this team. And, you know, Rondo has a chance to put himself in that echelon if he sticks around Boston in terms of being one of the all-time great Celtics.
And the 76ers making a change here. Thompson's checked in. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. And there's Richardson. That's good on the assist from Carter Williams.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
I think looking at the Sixers, anytime that you go through a 21-game losing streak during any point of the season, you know you're going to be near the bottom of the conference stand.
And Philadelphia will go for a different look here. Mbah Mute's checked in for Embiid. Grant comes in for Nerlens Noel. Arnett Moultrie's checked in for Richardson. And it's Alexei Shved in for Michael Carter-Williams. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Thank you, Kevin. Brad Stevens had some words for his team over the break. He didn't exactly take it easy on them, saying, "How much do you want it? Don't tell me. Show me out there. We have to play better. We have to play harder if we're going to come back. Guys?"
A shot by Thompson, and no one's around.
They've not had the same success from outside here in the second half that they did in the first. So it might make sense to look at going inside a little more this half.
There's Green with the three. Good. And it's Rondo who picks up the assist. Green's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Celtics. 76ers have gone 3-7 from the four in the fourth. That's a 42% mark in the quarter.
What is surprising about the 76ers last year, they had a long losing streak, but somehow managed not to finish at the bottom of the East.
Well, thinking of Philly in the East again, Clark, the fact that they didn't finish dead last after that losing streak says more about the conference than the 76ers.
Well, I guess I could agree with that. I mean, if you go 14-38 against the rest of the East like the 76ers did, you expect to be at the bottom, but amazingly, they avoided that last year. Actually, I will agree. It was more of a testament to the East and its lack of quality play.
That drops. And it's 8 points for Jared Sellinger.
Boy, what a great job making good on the second opportunity. He stayed with that play from start to finish. Where was he going with that pass? That's just an awful turnover.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They're trailing by 7. 1:24 left in the fourth quarter. And the 76ers with some changes. Sims is checked in, and Brandon Davies is subbed in for Moultrie. Here's the break. Here's Schved, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
And another thing they're doing is really taking advantage of fast break opportunities, scoring some easy baskets.
They're really doing a good job working hard to get inside and draw contact, a little more so than they did in the first half.
Well, to keep a lead like this, they should continue to attack the paint like they have been. Don't settle for jump shots. Find your way to the free throw line.
And it's Rondo penetrating Sullinger. That's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. That's 10 points for Jared Sullinger. Philadelphia leading by 6. Tries from 10. Davies with the bucket.
The defense playing way too soft there, guys. He's just getting right to the rim.
Boston's gone to three-point range 7 times tonight, knocked down 5 of them. Sullinger with the bucket.
Well, he certainly isn't the one to blame for them being in the hole. He's been on the money with his game.
Philadelphia's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter.
You know, he can be a little hesitant near the rim. We saw it there. If the defense offers just a little bit of resistance, he doesn't take it up quite strong enough.
That is a quick bucket. Pretty good in transition.
That's right. That's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
Misses off the left iron. Boston's gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Out to the wing, and a wide-open look for Rondo. No good with the triple. Money! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Huge points.
That's beyond huge, Steve. I mean, they needed that bucket. Desperate.
They foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point.
Well, you do what you have to do to extend this game and try to get the ball back.
In this situation, clock management, crucial.
He's able to hit the second one, and that makes it a 3-point lead. Timeout called by Boston. They're losing by 3. 16 seconds left in the game. Guys, what's your take?
Well, they've got 2 options here. They can go for the 3 and the tie, or the quick 2 and the foul.
I like the idea of going for the quick 2. Take it to the rim, and that wouldn't be a bad way to approach this situation.
Seconds left in the fourth quarter.
I thought he'd make that one. And that's his range, and the defense nowhere to be seen.
He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though. And he does get the second one, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. And the shot is long. They're going to prolong the game here with an intentional foul.
That's his third personal foul.
Gets the first, and that puts them up by 5.
Shooting for Philadelphia, Joel Embiid.
Second one is good. Hitting both at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game.
And that's exactly how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
So the 76ers win it. They came, they saw, they conquered.
Hey, Kevin, to me, any win is a good win.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Jason, obviously you began the game with a large lead. How did they creep back into this one?
We just wanted to get back in the game. We started being aggressive on the defense, and they got some easy layups. We can't do that, especially during the season. When you bury a team, you got to figure out a way to keep them buried.
No doubt, Jason. Thank you so much. Kevin?
Doris, thank you. And for Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke, and the rest of our great 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for joining us as Jordan presents our